Guys, out here today, cold, 8-degree day. Figured I'd get out early in the morning, get a solid day's worth of work done here at the base camp. I got some food to cook up today. I got some plans drawn up for the shelter and for the camp. So, follow me now. Well, guys, figured today would be a great day to get out to the base camp. It's a calm, cold day here in Ohio. It's probably about between 5 and 10 degrees Fahrenheit right now, and I'm feeling it. I'm cold. It's the first real cold weather we've had here this winter, and I gotta get to work. What I plan on doing today is working a lot on the base camp and cooking up some food. I got some eggs and bacon to cook up for breakfast, and I got a steak for my lunch slash dinner. I got a lot of plans drawn up for this base camp, a lot of work, a lot of features to add on, and we'll see how much I can get done today. First order is getting a fire together, prepping some kindling for a little fire though, because it's cold out, and with this camera, cold metal tripod, I'm gonna need to get some heat. Well, I don't want to be sitting on the cold ground today when I'm cooking and stuff, and I don't even have a chair put together yet. So first order of business is to find like a big stump or something I can drag over here to sit on, to put next to the fire, so that when I cook, I ain't sitting in the snow. And being it's winter, it's gonna be nice to have a little fire going during the day. So if I need to warm up, I can stop, take a break, and warm up. Look. Boom. That was pretty cool. I must have woke up a little baby rabbit. As soon as I walked by the camera, it was right there. Just darted off. Little rabbit. Could be my pet. Or he could be my dinner. Those puffballs. Ooh, that'll be my seat for now. So what I learned last video is that the size of the roof on this lean-to is perfect for my 10 by 10 tarp. Since I shot that video, I've kind of been trying to decide how do I want to do this roof. A lot of you guys offered some pretty good suggestions as to how I could quickly put up a roof. Kind of over the last week, I've decided that for the time being, I'm gonna put a tarp up, but the tarp's coming down with me each time I leave the campsite. One, because it's a good tarp, and I don't wanna leave it out here. It's a good tarp, I wanna keep it with my kit. I'm not gonna use the tarp for the roof of the shelter long term. I'm gonna just put in the work and gather the materials that I need to do an all natural shelter that's waterproof. So it's gonna take some time, it's gonna take some work. There might be a little bit of trial and error with it, but that's what I wanna do. I wanna do this place legit. No shortcuts. As of right now, I'm just gonna put the tarp up. I'm gonna cook a little breakfast, and I probably won't get to doing the roof today, but long term, I'm making this roof for real. It's gonna be awesome. So I'm gonna tie this tarp up before I get breakfast going. Pardon any snot molecules that you might see during this video, but my face is cold. I gotta go find some wood for the fire. All the stuff I had sitting on the ground at the camp, as you can imagine, it's covered in snow, it's damp, and it's rotten. So I gotta find some stuff that's hopefully dry standing. Take back to build up this fire for breakfast. Pretty good. The problem with pine is I feel like it's so, I don't know what the word is, the opposite of dense. it kind of rots quickly. As soon as there's a pine tree that dies, it falls and it rots in one year, it feels like. But this one should be good. I'm gonna take this and the other piece all the way up to camp. I just brought my two big pieces of pine back to the camp. I'm gonna put together this saw that I got. Man, these things are hard to put together, especially when your hands are cold. These saws are kind of tricky. Cool design in the grain of that wood. This pine makes feather sticks for days. This is the first wood that I was gonna use for the fire. It wouldn't split, it's real nasty stuff. So I'm just gonna throw it on as the base of my fire to keep the fire up off the ground. Don't you get a big tree and you split it up and you got those little weird pieces that where all the branches came from. That's what you can do, build a little kindling tree. Attack!
Look at the antler bone.
Took a little bit of time to get the fire built up. Building a fire in the winter is a whole different story. You gotta go overkill on fire prep. I had it built up the pine burned away real quick, and it wasn't even burning long enough to get the hardwood stuff that I had in a pile over here to ignite. I mean, it was kind of sitting in the snow, but it's going now. That feels real good. Feels nice to get the fire going finally. Been out here 3 hours freezing. Right here. You see this one right here? I think it's an ash tree. And it's definitely dead. There's a lot of ash tree here in this region that it got messed up by those beetles coming in to burrow into the tree and they eat it up. I don't know if they give a disease to the tree or they just chew up the tree, I don't really know, but there's quite a few ash trees near the base camp that I can take out to make a raised bed or a bench and firewood. So I think I'd take this one out right now. All right, well, I got a couple little pieces of dry hardwood that was right up here by my camp. Time to cook breakfast. Today for breakfast, I've got 2 eggs, 5 pieces of bacon. Whew. Yeah, let's get to cooking. Bacon overboard. Oh man! Whew. Thin bacon cooks quick.
Need a bacon.
All right, we're gonna save some of this bacon grease for my eggs.
Dang!
Dirty lens. Two eggs, peppers, and onions.
Look at it. Look at it flip, boy.
Get away from the camp. Too much smoke. All right, definitely not the prettiest looking breakfast I ever made. We got 5 pieces of bacon and some sort of omelet, onions and peppers. Ah, let's try it out. Oh, I forgot the cheese. Dang it, I forgot to put the cheese on.
Look at all the flavor on that wall. Look at the pepper. Look at the browning.
Good. Good foods. Bacon? Nice. Bacon? Nice and crispity.
Mmm. It is tasty. It's really good, so I can't complain too much. But I'm gonna finish up breakfast. Then get to working on the camp. That's why I came out here today, to keep working on this base camp. One of the things that's nice about winter camping, you can take perishable food out. You can bring whatever you want out to do winter camping. I got a steak for dinner, so. Summertime, everything's so hot. You really are kind of limited by what you take out in the summertime, if you're going on a multi-day trip, especially.
Just got done eating, and this is how much of the wall I got done last time I was out here. The wall, I kind of want to build all the way up. So basically what I need to do is gather pieces of wood and lash them to the frame to complete this wall. Well, basically, I'll use my saw as like a measuring stick to see how long I need to make these pieces. I think I'm just gonna start lashing them from here to here. So I need to go one, two, about three lengths of the saw. It's my first cut. And each piece just goes a little shorter.
Adventure sworn, bucksaw. You kidding me? Broke on me. I think this will do. Stick this in instead of the piece that broke. I think this will work. Dude, I'm just a pure bushcrafter. Look at that. Time to get back to work. That's how you turn one piece into two. Thank you. All right, so Canadian jam knot, one end of the string, one end of the paracord has a knot and another knot that you don't pull all the way tight because then you pull the other end of the string through it. The problem is that I never know, am I supposed to come through this side or this side? And it definitely makes a difference because half of these knots I'm tying are slipping and the other half aren't. So one way is correct and the other way is not. Like this, it's not even sliding. The point of this knot is for it to slide up there, and it's not even sliding. Ah, all right, there it goes, there it goes. Ugh. The crappiest knot. I wish there was a better knot. I wish there was a better knot for this thing because this knot is not, this knot ain't no good. I think I'm done with the wall today. I'm running out of energy and I'm running out of sunlight. I probably got an hour and a half before it's dark, so I gotta start gathering firewood to cook dinner. I got a good steak that I wanna cook up. So here's the progress so far. Exactly what I need. I got a couple pieces of pine left from this morning. And I still should have a couple of embers. So I'm gonna find one of them cedar trees and just bust off some of the twigs for my kindling. That should be good. Probably about 5 o'clock. I've been out here since 9 a.m. filming, cooking food, working on the base camp. I got the back or side wall, most of it done today. And yeah, going really well actually. I can give you kind of an idea now that the structure's starting to come together as to what else I want to do. I'm going to go down to the creek and I'm going to get stones so I can build up a fire pit. I'm gonna build a fire reflector behind it. And then I'm gonna build all kinds of different cooking implements like a tripod. Oh crap. An adjustable tripod. And that wall that's there, I'm probably gonna do another one over here. Yeah. So wall. This tarp is only temporary. I'm going to be building the roof out of the materials out here in the woods, and that's going to take a whole lot of time. I want it to be waterproof, and I think that's going to take a good amount of effort to put that all together. Frame it up grid style, and then
kind of weave some smaller stuff in between and then do leaf litter on top. I also want to make a chair and potentially a bed. Those are my immediate plans. Those are the things, the first things I'm going to do at this camp is do a bed, a chair, another wall, finish the roof, put together a fire pit with a cooking pod, cooking tripod, stuff like that. But this is going to be where I do all my videos from now on. Rather than just come to a little spot in the woods and put together a fire, this will be my area. Another thing I want to do is put together a big storage area for firewood, for dry firewood. So I got a good couple pieces of good wood on here. I'm going to let this cook down to coals, and then I'm going to cook up steak for dinner and sweet potato. So I'm looking forward to it. Been working hard all day, haven't eaten very much. I think this piece will be the official camp baton. So mark it, that way I don't use it for anything else. Been using this new Mora for the last month or two. This is the Mora Garberg. This is the first Mora that had the full tang, and you can even see it. Tang is exposed outside the pommel out there. Boy, do I love this knife. This is probably my favorite knife I have. It's got, you know, the typical Mora hard plastic handle. This is just a sweet knife, man. I love it for so many reasons. I'll do a knife review on it here shortly. This is the knife I've been using, Mora Garberg. Love that sheath. They're cool little knives. That's what I started off using when I first started getting in the woods, was a little Mora Companion. And it's just a nice, affordable knife, well built. And it's Scandi grind, so you can't go wrong with that. It's good for a little woodcraft, camping, bushcraft kind of stuff. All right, so I've never tried this, but I've got a sweet potato. I'm just gonna throw it in the fire. I'm just gonna toss it in the fire, or right next to the fire in the coals, and see how well it cooks. But steak and potatoes for dinner.
Can't go wrong with that.
I'm gonna take my remaining water that I've got. I have not drank enough water. I'm gonna take the remaining water that I have, heat it up by the fire, and have some tea for supper. All right, I'm gonna cook this with coconut oil.
I'm just trying to keep this potato rotating. Keep it in the heat, but might have to just toss it in the coals.
Freaking monster steak won't even fit in the pan. Can't even get the whole surface of it seared, so. Woo! Whatever, it's gonna be a good steak anyways. It's a good cut of meat, so it's gonna be tasty.
Potato. Water's hot for tea. And I got a nice little char on the steak.
Right. I think it's time to dig in. I don't think the potato's done, but
whatever.
Let's dig into this potato and see what we got.
And as I said, I didn't put the potato on long enough. So the inside's a bit hard.
Take a bite.
Man, sweet potatoes are good. I'm messy right now. Hands dirty. Overcooked the steak a little bit, but I suppose the thickest cut right here in the middle will have a little bit of color to it. But realistically, this is such a good cut of meat that it's gonna taste good no matter how you cook it, unless you burn it to cook it to death. Do you like a piece? Open up. I'll be working on this camp for like a year. Trust me, this thing takes a lot of work. Oh, I'm ready for a nap now. Anybody that's still watching, I appreciate you guys watching this one. I wanted to do a real long video, because I have a lot of people ask me to do them, and I said might as well. So filmed a lot more than usual today. Did a lot more talking than usual. So hopefully you guys like this video. I'm gonna come back here to base camp. Probably be a couple of weeks before I get back out here to base camp, but when I do, I've got plans. I got more stuff to do, so. Alright guys, well, I'm leaving camp now. Tired. Appreciate any of you guys that are still watching. This is a long one for sure. So, guys, until next time, ScrambledO signing off.